Students, now I'm going to explain you the poem Animal, which is poem number 7 of your first flight book. Animal is written by Walt Whitman. So before we begin, let me highlight on the salient feature of the poem today. First, I'll focus on short author biography, which will be followed by lesson synopsis and then explanation of vocabulary. I shall also throw some light on detailed explanation of the poem, which will be followed by literary devices, and towards the end, recapitulation of the poem. So here we begin. First, the lesson synopsis. The poem draws comparison between humans and animals. Unlike humans, animals do not complain and are always happier at their present state. Unlike humans, they do not commit sins and are very innocent and honest creatures. Animals possess all human virtues like honesty, truthfulness, etc., which humans once possessed long time ago. Now, let's move on to born in West Hills, Long Island, US on May 31st, 1819. He was the second child in a family of 11. In 1836, at the age of 17, he began his career as a teacher and continued to teach until 1841, when he turned to journalism as a full-time career. He founded a weekly newspaper, Long Islander, and later edited a number of Brooklyn and New York papers. Under the influence of the Romantic movement in literature and art, Whitman held the theory that the chief function of the poet was to express his own personality in his verse. Whitman is primarily known for his work Leaves of Grass. Now, next is our stanza-wise explanation. First stanza, I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. Here, my dear students, placid refers to quiet and calm. Self-contained means in full control of the self. So, what is the poet trying to say here? The poet longs or wishes to become an animal. Okay, why? Because animals, according to the poet, are calm and quiet, and they are self-contained. Means they do not look beyond themselves. They are busy with themselves only. Unlike human beings, they do not interfere in the matters of other human beings. Understood? The human beings do interfere in the matters of other human beings, but animals, they never do. They are self-contained. The poet wishes to turn to animals and live with them. Then the animals, unlike human beings, are so calm and quiet and are in full control of the self. They do not look into the matters of others like humans do. Now, next stanza is stanza 2. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Dear students, here, sweat and whine refers to complain here, to cry, to complain. Duty to God refers to religious duties and responsibilities that human beings tend to carry out. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. Unlike human beings, animals do not make complaints and cry about their conditions. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. Animals do not remain awake till late at night and cry for their wrong deeds like human beings do. Okay, they do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Animals are innocent and simple creatures, unlike human beings. They do not worry about their duty to God. Here, what the poet means to say is that in spite of doing sins, human beings talk about God and scriptures. On the other hand, animals, being so innocent, do not need to turn to God for confession or asking forgiveness. Here, the poet means to say that in spite of human being making or committing so many sins, they still turn to religion. They are hypocrite. Okay? Whereas animals are innocent, so they don't need to be hypocrites, then don't need to turn to God, unlike human beings. Now let's move on to stanza 3. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with the mania of owning things. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. Here, my dear students, demented refers to affected with madness, craze. Mania of owning things means the madness for possessing things is called mania of owning things. Okay, so no one is dissatisfied means no animal is dissatisfied, okay, over himself. No one is demented with the mania of owning. Animals do not have the tendency of owning things like human beings. Human beings have a desire to possess more and more things, whereas the animals do not have such desire. The desire to own things by human beings has been called madness here by the poet. Animals, unlike humans, are never dissatisfied and has no madness about possessing material thing. Okay, so animals do not kneel down to other animals as they have no sense of hierarchical pride. Human beings kneel down to another. Okay, human beings tend to flatter another, whereas animals do not have to flatter or kneel down to another animal because they do not have the realization of hierarchical order. They do not have any hierarchical pride. No one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. As all animals are self-contained and equal, there is no question of respect to some and insult to others. They are never unhappy like human beings. Next stanza, that is stanza 4. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince them plainly in their possession. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass the way huge times ago and negligently drop them? Here, dear students, token refers to good qualities here. Evince means display, to show something. Huge times ago, ego refers to long, long time ago. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. Animals seem to have what humans once had. Virtues like kindness, self-containment, and innocence. Human beings did have such virtues, but not at the present time. They had long, long time ago. Therefore, the poet is regretting here. Human beings have taken leave of their senses. They have taken a leave of the virtues that they are supposed to have. They are no longer having such virtues like kindness, self-contentment, and innocence. So animals remind the poet, animals have such virtues. So the poet thinks that such virtues of human beings might have been transferred to animals. Therefore, animals are displaying them, whereas human beings are lacking such virtues. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince. They here refers to animals. Animals show such human qualities, okay, whereas human beings do not show. Okay, these human qualities are in their possession, in the possession of the animals, whereas human beings are not having any kind of virtue in modern day world. I wonder where they get those tokens. The poet is wondering now, where animals got such human virtues from? Did I pass that way? Did any human being pass that human virtue to animals long, long time ago? And transferred those virtues to the animals for a longer period of time? So the poet is saying here that a long, long time ago, human beings were having such virtues, but they passed it on to animals, and since then animals are having them and human beings have no virtue at all. So at last the poet introspects himself and wonders Whether animals picked up those human virtues when he dropped them carelessly long, long time ago. So now let's move on to the literary devices. First is anaphora. Anaphora is the use of repeated words at the beginning of two or more consecutive lines. Here, use of they do not. Then metaphor, sweat and wine refer to the cries and complaints of human beings. Then repetition, they do not sweat, no one is dissatisfied. So these are repeated in the poem. And alliteration, as I told you in my previous video as well, the repetition of consonant sounds, that is, they do not make me sick. And other sentences, as you can observe in the poem in course of your reading. Now, my dear students, whatever we have learned so far is something okay. So, dear students, this poem draws comparison between human beings and animals, and then unlike humans, animals do not complain and they are always happy at their present state. Unlike humans, animals do not commit any sins and are very innocent and honest creatures. Animals possess all human qualities, virtues like honesty and truthfulness, etc., which humans once possessed long, long time ago. Therefore, the poet longs to play the role of animals, okay, so that he enjoys the company of animals. Human beings have lost their virtues. They have lost their values. All the virtues and values seem to have eroded as time passed on. So it's a regret on the part of the poet for being human beings, because he can see everywhere around those human basic virtues are lacking. So that is what he wanted to convey to us, that human beings must have certain values which they are not having. Animals are having such virtues. So the gradual erosion of human values has been highlighted in the poem. Hope you have understood. Thank you so much. And for question answers, please refer to my blog, which is English with Manatushde.blogspot.in. Thank you so much.